Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. So this is the face paper title of this project called Enabling Trustworthy Service Evaluation in Service Oriented Mobile Social Networks. This is the abstract of this paper. In this paper, they systematically analyze the threat that is posed by the cyber attack to wireless sensor networks. A key problem is that such a monitor must execute in an untested environment, that is, at the service provider site. Thus, the integrity of the results reported by such a monitor crucially depends on its integrity. Strong RSA was previously used, that is, in the existing system, to construct the signature schemes without any random oracles. However, signatures generated by our proposed scheme are much shorter and simpler than signatures from schemes based on the strong RSA. Furthermore, here we have provides a limited form of message recovery. This is the data flow diagram of this project. Here I have considered a service vendor and a service user. So these two persons can log in using their valid username and password, which can be generated during the registration. So other unauthorized persons will be discarded from the entry. So after the successful entry of the vendor, he can generate a key pairs with the combination of a public key and a private key. So and then he can publish only the public key to all successful login users. First, the user one will start requesting for a token. With the help of this token only, he can submit his own service review to the vendor. So after he get the requested token, he will just validate this received token with the help of the previously received public key. If those tokens gets validated, means he can generate his own review, and those generated reviews can be attached with the generated token and will be sent to the vendor, so that he can update his TP list, which is maintained here, about the users, every users and his corresponding tokens, and those tokens can be validated with the help of the timestamp. So after the successful submission of the first user service review, he just passed over his token to the second user when he just asked for the token request, and using that second token, he can also just generate his own review, and those own review can also be aggregated along with the first user's review if he going to submit it to the same vendor. So those aggregated reviews can be sent to the vendor again, and this process, timestamp process validations, will be repeated in the vendor form. At last, the valid tokens users service review can only be decrypted to publish to the users. Other timeout tokens users review cannot be published or decrypted anymore. Now I can show you the demo of this project starting from its home page, which displays the waste paper title right here. Just click the center button to move on to the login form. Here I have to choose a category as a service vendor and enter his unique user ID and his password, which gets validated for a successful login. And here we have considered two types of service agency called travel agency and hotel agency. Here I can generate a key pair using the RSA algorithm, which has its both public key and private key. Here they can extract the users which has been registered under this travel agency. So here these generated public keys should be updated in the database, and then just log in as a users now. So just change this category and enter a ID and this password, which gets matched. So here it gets the basic details of the login the users, and just click this receive key to receive the broadcasting public key and log in as a second user. And just click this receive key and open this form and just click this broadcast, which the public keys can be broadcasted to all the logged in users right here. So just open any one of the users and ask for the token request. So here they can select his ID and generate a token request like this, which can be sent to the vendors. So just open this generate token from the vendor package and click the same port numbers to receive the user's request. So these requests can be validated using the generated public key. Once it is validated, we can generate a token for the requesting user. Just change the port numbers and these generated tokens can be sent to the requested user. So just run this service review from service users package and just enter the same port number to receive the generated token from the vendor. So these tokens should also be validated using the public key. So here now they can select any one of the ratings and can just start typing about the service. And just get the public key and start encryption using the AES encryption methods. So also it should generate a secret key using the MD5. So here it should generate a token acknowledgement for the vendor side. So after this encrypted form, they can submit this service review to the vendor. So just update this TP list which gets displayed in here along with the user ID and its corresponding token number and the session number and its corresponding rating. Just select this corresponding ID to validate this token with the help of this timestamp which gets generated during the token generation. So if this timestamp is within the 15 minutes or within the threshold level, means it can decrypt those reviews and those reviews can be published to the public. So after this successful decryption, we can evaluate the comparison of the security with the existing system called the basic TSE and proposed ETSE, and we can also calculate its corresponding memory consumptions. So after this process, we can change over to the next second user's token request and just change the port number and send this token request to the first user, so that we should end this user's token generation from service user package and just type the same port number to receive the token request of first user and just validate his request using the public key and then generate the token for the second user. And then this generated token has to be sent to the requested second user and then run this aggregate review.java from service user package to receive the generated token like this. After this it gets a token acknowledgement at the vendor side and then we can validate these received token has been sent from the valid vendor or not, and then we have to detach the first user's review and his corresponding secret hash key, and using this encrypted form Here the second user should also generate a secret key as K2. If these both keys gets matched, means he can only encrypt, otherwise it do not enable the encrypt button. So after the successful validation, he can just pick any one of the ratings and its descriptions like this. And just get the public key and encrypted the second user's review. And here we have obtained the hash key, that is secret key of this corresponding second user's review, along with the aggregated encrypted text of the first user, and this is the encrypted text of the second user. So these reviews can get submitted to the vendors. So same thing, here we have to update the TP list for the second user and just pick out the second user's ID and just validate for the timestamp. So after the validate of the timestamp, he can just decrypt the review like this and can generate the graph of the corresponding security and memory consumption. So that's all. Thanks for listening.